Welcome to Dental and Ayurveda, a channel for basic Ayurvedic and dental sciences. Our today's chapter is Pneumococcus of Microbiology. And the topics we'll be studying will include morphology, culture, diagnosis, resistance, treatment, etc. related to Pneumococcus bacteria.
Hello everyone. So in this video, we are going to talk about pneumococcus, also known as streptococcus pneumoniae. So these are gram-positive and spherical bacteria and they affect the upper respiratory tract. So they are important pathogens of pneumonia and otitis media in children. So this is common in children. Then we are going to talk about its morphology. These are gram-positive and they have a very small diameter of 1 micrometers. And they are elongated cocci and always arranged in pairs. Then they are capsulated and the capsule encloses each pair. So each pair in the capsule and they are non-motile and non-sporing. Then we are going to talk about the culture. So basically ये aerobes and facultative anaerobes होते हैं और इनकी जो growth होती है it is improved by 5 to 10% CO2 में होती है. Then the optimum temperature for growth is 37 degree Celsius and pH is like 7.8. Then on blood agar after incubation for 18 hours these colonies are small, dome shaped and greenish discoloration is you can see around these colonies. And on prolonged incubation, the colonies become flat with raised edges and this results in appearance of concentric rings. Then some biochemical reactions. So, pneumococci produce only acid on fermentation of several sugars. Then fermentation of inulin by pneumococci is of great value to make them different from streptococci. So, this is the difference. Then bile solubility test is done. You can see that they are soluble in bile. An important diagnostic test to differentiate pneumococcus from the other streptococcus is this. So this particular test is very important when 25% sodium glycolate solution is added to broth culture. So then we talk about resistance. So these pneumococci are delicate organisms and they are destroyed at 52 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. So, ये बहुत sensitive होते हैं to, you know, usual antiseptics. An optogen sensitivity test is done for this. When an optogen disc, which is 5 micrograms, is applied on blood agar plate, inoculated with pneumococci, wide zone of inhibition occurs on incubation, during incubation. Then, antigenic structure. So, most important antigen of pneumococcus is capsular polysaccharide. So, another antigen are also there like somatic M protein and a group of specific cell wall carbohydrates are there. So first we are going to talk about capsular polysaccharide. Ye type specific hote hain and as these polysaccharides are soluble in tissue and culture fluid, it is going to diffuse into the culture medium or tissues and infective exudates. So these are also known as soluble specific substances. SSS. So this is about capsular polysaccharide and these definitely these are type specific. Then we have that pneumococci are classified into types on which basis? On the basis of nature of the capsular polysaccharide. So like more than 90 serotypes are there. So 1, 2, 3 and so on, these are named like this. And serological typing of pneumococcus is carried out by three methods. First is the agglutination of organisms with type-specific antisera. You can see here. And then precipitation of capsular polysaccharide with type-specific antiserum. Then is quelling reaction or you can also call it as capsule swelling reaction. So in this reaction, the suspension of pneumococcus, we mix karte hain with a drop of antiserum. So this mixing is done. Then we talk about that the capsule which you can see around the pneumococci Okay, so this capsule is going to show an appearance of a swelling. So there will be some swelling. Then we have M proteins. So this is the characteristic feature for each pneumococci. Then cell wall carbohydrates, you can call it as C substance. So all the pneumococci, they contain C substance, which is a species-specific carbohydrate antigen. Then this C substance is precipitated by an abnormal protein, जिसको हम कहते हैं बीटा ग्लोब्यूलिन, एंड दैट अपियर्स इन अक्यूट फेज सेरा ऑफ केसेस ऑफ निमोनिया. बट ये दिस इज गोइंग टू डिसअपियर ड्यूरिंग कॉन्वेलेसेंस. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड सी रिएक्टिव प्रोटीन भी हम इसे कहते हैं. देन इट्स प्रोडक्शन इज एक्चुअली स्टिमुलेटेड बाय बैक्टीरियल इन्फेक्शन, एनी मेलिग्नेंसीज और टिश्यू डिस्ट्रक्शन की वजह से ये स्टिमुलेट हो जाता है इसका प्रोडक्शन. एंड डेफिनेटली इट इज यूज इन रूमेटिक फीवर एंड सम अदर कंडीशन ऑल्सो. देन यू हैव वेरिएशन. सो न्यूमोकोकस इज वायरुलेंट इन कैप्सुलेटेड फॉर्म, बट इट इज बी एन एवायरुलेंट इन नॉन कैप्सुलेटेड फॉर्म, फॉर्म्स मीन्स रफ फॉर्म्स. सो ऑन रिपीटेड सब कल्चर अ स्मूथ टू रफ वेरिएशन इज गोइंग टू अकर. एंड देन वी टॉक अबाउट सम टॉक्सिन्स एंड अदर वायरुलेंस फैक्टर्स दैट दे हैव. सो न्यूमोकोकाई इज बेसिकली गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस एन ऑक्सीजन लेबाइल इंट्रासेलुलर हीमोलाइसिन एंड अ ल्यूकोसाइटिन. ओके, देन द वायरुलेंस ऑफ न्यूमोकोकाई, ये पूरा वायरुलेंस डिपेंड करता है ऑन इट्स कैप्स्यूल, विच इज गोइंग टू प्रिवेंट और इनहिबिट फैगोसाइटोसिस. देन यू कैन सी समथिंग अबाउट पैथोजेनेसिस. देन स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस निमोनिया इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन बैक्टीरिया, ओके, विच इज कॉजिंग बोथ लोबार एंड ब्रोंकोनिमोनिया, टू टाइप्स ऑफ निमोनिया. वॉट इज लोबार निमोनिया? कॉमन इन्फेक्टिव टाइप्स ऑफ स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस निमोनिया आर लाइक टाइप 1 to 12 इन अडल्ट एंड टाइप 6 and 23 इन चिल्ड्रन. सो निमोनिया अकर्स ओनली वेन द जनरल रेजिस्टेंस इज लोअर. जब का जनरल रेजिस्टेंस कम हो जाता है तभी निमोनिया ज्यादा अफेक्ट करता है. देन वी हैव ब्रोंको निमोनिया. सो इट इज बेसिकली सेकेंडरी इन्फेक्शन फॉलोइंग द वायरल इन्फेक्शन ऑफ रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट. सो इट इज एक्चुअली अ सेकेंडरी इन्फेक्शन ब्रोंको निमोनिया. एंड देन वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट मेनिंजाइटिस. सो दिस इज लाइक मोस्ट सीरियस meningitis, most serious pneumococcal infection, and this meningitis is very common in children. Children mein bahut common hota hai. Then streptococcus pneumonia is the most, like second most important cause of pyogenic meningitis after end meningitis. Then we have some other infections. It can be like, you know, this may produce some complications like pericarditis, otitis media, sinusitis, conjunctivitis, okay, peritonitis. So all these are certain complications which can occur. Then we'll talk about lab diagnosis. So in lab diagnosis, specimens, so you know, we collect all the samples like sputum, CSF, then any pleural exudate or blood. Then we collect it according to the site of lesion. Then we are going to collect and transport the specimen in sterile containers, you know, make sure that everything is sterilized properly. And in case of delay, the CSF specimen should never be refrigerated. So we refrigerate nahi karenge, we are going to keep it at 37 degrees Celsius. Then in lab diagnosis, another thing done is direct microscopy and antigen detection. So isme gram staining of smear reveals a large number of polymorphs and typical organisms. Then, you know, swelling of capsule is also there when the pneumococci are mixed with type specific antisera. And in case of meningitis, presumptive diagnosis may be, like it may be made by finding gram positive diplococci, which will be intracellular as well as extracellular in smear. So, you know, then capsular polysaccharide antigen can be demonstrated by counter immuno electrophoresis as in blood cerebrospinal fluid. So antigen we detected by immunochromatographic assay, then latex agglutination or coagulation. Then we talk about culture. So specimen is inoculated on blood agar, and then ye jo incubate karenge hum ise 37 degree Celsius pe, in presence of CO2. These colonies, they develop with alpha hemolysis, and then we talk about colony morphology and staining. So these colonies are small with alpha hemolysis around them. And जब हम ये ग्राम स्टेनिंग करेंगे सो दीज ब्यूमोकोकाई आर ग्राम पॉजिटिव दे विल बी स्मॉल ओके देन दे विल बी ऑब्वियसली पेयर डिप्लोकोकाई एंड फ्लेम शेप्ड होंगे देन सम बायोकेमिकल रिएक्शन इफ आई टॉक अबाउट सो इम्पोर्टेंट बायोकेमिकल टेस्ट जो हम इसमें करते हैं इसके लिए दैट आर इन्यूलिन फर्मेंटेशन एंड बायल सॉल्युबिलिटी टेस्ट एंड ऑल्सो ऑप्टोजन सेंसिटिविटी टेस्ट वी डू देन एनिमल पैथोजेनिसिटी In this, from specimens where organisms are expected to be scanty, like intraperitoneal inoculation in mice, we used. We can use that. So, inoculated mice die in 24 to 48 hours. So, heart, blood, and peritoneal exudate. Okay. Heart, blood, and peritoneal exudate of the animal it will show pneumococci. You can find pneumococci there. Then we have talk about treatment. So the antibiotic that is given is basically parenteral penicillin, and cephalosporin is indicated for penicillin resistant stains, like strains. Like if penicillin is resistant, then we can give cephalosporin as.
Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. And ready to need notes of this chapter are available on our Instagram page, whose link is given in the description box. So follow us there too.